Take a look at this. Pretty strong numbers for former President Trump. Want Donald Trump to run again? Republican primary voters, by a margin of 73%, say yes. This poll is from John McLaughlin of McLaughlin and Associates. He did the polling for President Trump in 2016 and 2020. Thanks for being here. We're also joined by Congressman Devin Nunes, Republican of California. Welcome, gentlemen. Congressman Nunes, what do you think of these numbers?
Well, what's surprising to me is these are higher numbers than Donald Trump ever had in the 2016 primary. So he clearly has the lead. You know, in my discussions with him, he said his priority is to ensure that we win the House and get the Senate back. And I know he's working hard doing that every day. So, you know, in politics, as John McLaughlin knows, it's a long time to 2024. And I think the key will be for us to field really solid candidates across the board and drive home election victories. And then if that happens, I think Donald Trump would be well positioned to run in 2024.
Let's put up the Ipsos Reuters poll. 56% of Republicans believe the election in 2020 was tainted. 56 of Republicans believe it was tainted. I have grave concerns about the fairness of the election. Congressman, first to you on this.
Well, I would say one thing. How about how many Democrats believe that the Russians and Putin stole the election for Trump in 2016, which was a hoax? As it relates to tainted, I mean, it's a very strange word to pull on, but I think it's hard to say that it wasn't tainted. And I think what we really need to get our hands around is what's happening now, the reason that we wanted paper ballots. We spent a year, House Intelligence Committee Republicans did, in this whole Russia hoax investigation. One of the things we said is, look, we need to have paper ballots. Well, now that we have paper ballots, then we ought to be able to go in and do recounts. I think that's problematic. Also, the states need to go in and ensure that there's election integrity. And finally, I would say, we still don't have an accounting of for the $350 million that Facebook spent. And we understand that it might have been as much as $500 million. We still don't have an accounting for that. And that money went in to support supposed nonprofits that, in one case in Green Bay, the keys to the election office were given over to somebody. That's what they mean by tainted. So it ought to be a hell of a lot higher than that, because look, the election for sure has a taint to it. And the longer that we don't get to the bottom of it and do recounts, I think the more the people are going to be ticked off.
9/11 and 1/6, January 6th of this year and September 11th are somehow on the same level. That George Will, the Republican, said that, the conservative said that these were equal in shock to the system. This is offensive. This is ludicrous. 3,000 people were killed on 9/11. One, a Trump supporter, was killed on January 6th. But boy, oh boy, they're really trying to, they won't give up on January 6th, will they, Congressman?
No, they won't. And I think the more they push on this and the more that they call everybody racist, I'm actually shocked that that number you showed was only 28%, yeah, as much as the propaganda machine has been out there. And so they're not going to let this die. The left doesn't want to let this die. But the problem is, per usual, once the facts begin to come out, things don't look right. And I will say this, we still don't know. And these are basic questions that I've been asking. Tell me how many people actually carried a hammer, broke windows, or aided and abetted those people that destroyed federal property. Why won't you show us the videotapes? Republicans have yet to see the videotapes of what happened on January 6th. Why are they not showing us the videotapes? And why do we not know who broke the windows and damaged public property? Because I'll tell you, I am all for those people that broke those windows going to jail for a long time. But what I am not for is for people to be sitting in jail. Like, I understand there's very few people reporting on this right now, but as I understand it, there are people sitting in jail right now who are having their due process rights violated. And I've talked to a lot of people who said, hey, we didn't even know that we couldn't be in the Capitol. And I always have to remind people, it is your right as an American citizen to be in the US Capitol. Now, I can't help it that Pelosi is locking everybody out, but it is the people's house. And I'm sure that a lot of people that marched there, the doors were wide open at the time after the people broke them, and after some time when some of the doors were just wide open. But 80% of those people probably had no clue that they couldn't be there, because on any normal day, an American citizen or anyone for that matter, you don't have to be an American citizen, You can walk into my office, walk right through the door, and go get a tour of the Capitol.
Yeah. Yeah, no, and there are people like the Horns guy. The Horns guy is still in jail. He didn't break anything, and he didn't hurt anybody. He's still in jail. Can I ask you, Congressman, about Ashley Babbitt? Ashley Babbitt was an unarmed Trump supporter. She may have been breaking the law. She may have been trespassing, but she did not deserve to be shot that day. I heard no warning offered by the officer who fired his weapon and killed her. And everybody seems to be just kind of whatever. Very little interest in this. I'm still interested in it. The questions have not been answered.
Well, I think that's typically what you see. You see that all the time. Whenever it's a Republican who has a shooting incident of some kind, all they do is call for new gun laws. However, or whenever somebody gets killed by a police officer, all they do is say that, well, the police officer must have been racist. In this case, I just want to reiterate what I said right before, and that is we haven't even seen the videotapes. And we have committees in the House of Representatives. There should be no reason why, and I don't know the exact number. I'm told it's like 24,000 hours or something. I have no idea if that's correct. Why don't the committees of jurisdiction, where we have everything, why aren't they going through and looking at those videotapes? Why don't we have the name released of the police officer who shot this young lady, who, you know, quite frankly, it could have been justified, right? I mean, we don't know. And that's a problem. Here we are 4 or 5 months later. Nobody knows. Evidence is being suppressed. People are being locked in jail. And all we hear is the Democrats, oh, they want to have a 9/11 style commission. I say hell no to that.
Congressman Nunes, you've been so brave and such a leader on all these issues there where so few want to go. We thank you for that for years now. And John McLaughlin, I want to put up that poll number finally as we go to break. Let's see here. 82% of Republicans will vote for Trump in 2024. That is quite a number. You know the president very well. What's he thinking right now?
Well, I think he's thinking about getting the House back and stopping Pelosi and make it, you know, getting Congressman Nunes back to be a chairman of a committee or in leadership, because he's a hero to most Americans.
Absolutely. How about Speaker? I think that sounds pretty good, too.
I think so.
Okay. Thank you, gentlemen. Oh, by the way, Donald Trump will be on Newsmax tonight with Cortez and Pellegrino. It should be great. I'll be right back.